It's official. Ian Halpern is reporting it.
What?
Yep. Oh.
I saw Ian this weekend, by the way, with this beautiful fucking smoking hot chick that we spoke to on the phone.
So he's not bullshitting?
No! She's holy fucking sexy.
Call girl.
And it was normal Ian.
Must be a call girl.
No, dude, it was
normal.
She remember being
I'm
on the
not
phone.
On the radio, Ian.
He was a really, he's a sweet guy. We hung out.
I kind of liked him off the air.
I like Ian off the air a lot. He's actually a really nice dude.
He's a real
dude.
Douche when he's on our show, but as soon as these mics go off, he's really a nice guy.
He's a great guy. He came to one of the nasty shows, and we talked for a little while after. He's recommending restaurants. He's really a sweet guy.
Down to earth.
Great. Yeah, very,
dare
very normal.
I say. We're waiting for Ian Halperin. We haven't heard from Ian in a while, and he's in Stockholm.
I told you, I saw him in Montreal.
Stockholm.
And it was normal Ian. Like, he had a really hot girl with him, and he was just pleasant.
I like Ian.
I do like him a lot, but I mean, he was just like, you know, giving restaurant suggestions in Montreal. He's a good guy to go out to dinner with or whatever. He's a very normal
really?
Guy. Yeah, he really is. Nice guy.
And with that, Ian Halperin.
Oh,
he's here.
His Highness.
Ian. Man, there's a. You guys got to be in Stockholm with me. First of all, Norton delivered the show of the whole gig was about Norton. I'm telling you, everyone else they were mediocre, but that comedy fest would have bombed. I'm not kidding you.
Thanks,
man. I had a Norwegian chick with me that night who loves comedy, and she right now is talking about Norton up in. There's some comedy festival up there this week, by the way. I'm in Sweden right now, but dude, you know how to deal, man.
Thank you, man.
You had the audience in the palm of your hand.
Thank you.
And that's the key. Everyone else was a bit nervous up there, with all due respect to them. You could tell. It was like Norton was like A-Rod, just hitting homers,
Norton.
And the rest were like Shelly Duncans, you know, a bit nervous, swinging at all kinds of pitches. Where's my man Anthony, man?
Hi, how you doing, Ian?
It's His Highness to you, bro.
Oh, His Highness, how are you? What's His going Highness. On? What are you doing in Stockholm?
What do you think I'm doing here, man? You think I'm fucking playing, you know, Snakes and Ladders, dude? I'm fucking banging, dude.
What's Snakes and Ladders?
No, it's the Canadian version of fucking...
Oh.
Yeah, it's like Chutes and Ladders with lawyers.
Yeah. I'm on a mission here undercover, and I know you're going to say it's not true. It's not true. You know,
why would I say that? You've done nothing but show that you're legit and on the up and up every time you're on the show.
I came here with a mission to get close to the princess of Sweden. And I've been stalking her the last few days. She's a woman who was in a sex scandal a few months back. She was banging the goalie of the New York Rangers, Lundqvist.
Oh, yeah?
Okay.
Who I think's a stiff, by the way. I think the Rangers should turf him. They should have signed the Canadiens goaler, Hollick, who was just traded. Because he's not a winner, this guy. You know, all Swedish players, they're all good until the playoffs. They all choke. You know, like most European players. But anyhow, so I've been stalking her, getting close to her. I was at a party last night. And I should email Norton these pictures, which I will. You know, dude, a Swedish fashion party last night, His Highness, maybe two other guys and 400 Swedish chicks. How much better can that be?
Jesus.
Nice.
How much better does it get?
Can't beat you up on that one, Ian. That's nice.
Oh, it felt like I'd died and gone to heaven, man.
Hey, how do you go undercover, though? Because you're very recognizable with the big glasses and the loud suits
Sweden,
and stuff.
Sweden, they know me, man, because I've been on all the talk shows here promoting my movies. I was on Skavlan. Have you heard of this show called Skavlan?
No.
It's the Swedish talk show. It's bigger than the Tonight Show. I thought, you know, why the fuck should I go on this show? They called me. I tried to bail 2 days before the show. They said, dude, no one has fucking ever bailed on this show. We had Jay-Z on last week, Rihanna 2 weeks ago, and who the fuck are you to bail on us? So I fucking trekked to Sweden, never heard of this stiff in my life, go on the show, and the next fucking day I can't walk the streets of Stockholm. Everybody and their uncle watches that show. It's on Friday night. It's bigger than Jonathan Ross.
So, once again, I ask, how do you go undercover then?
Yeah.
You're certainly not undercover.
I'm in disguise right now, man.
What's your disguise?
I just put on new shades and,
you
know.
Maybe slick the hair back a little.
Yeah, you know,
put a little shoe polish in it.
Yeah, you know, change the color of the costume, the whole thing. But
yeah.
But yeah, I've been following the Swedish princess the last few days and have got pretty close to her.
And now, what are you looking to get from her?
Pussy.
All right.
His Highness only likes royal pussy.
What would you do to her?
I smelled her puss last night. I was at a party with her.
Yeah.
She had two bodyguards behind her. I was making them so nervous, man. I thought they were going to jump me. They were but she likes me, this princess, man.
Really?
So she's always putting her arm around me, and I could smell her puss last night. Like, she was wearing a short skirt. And I don't think she was wearing underwear under there. I kept looking. There was not even floss in the back.
And it was just
really?
And it was just wafting?
Oh, dude. I think I would love, you know, Anthony.
What does Swedish pussy smell like, Ian Halperin?
Well, I banged a few Swedish chicks before.
Yeah, so what does it smell like down there?
Meatballs with hair on it.
Those are good. You know, it's much different than the Bronx, than, let's say,
Jesus.
You know, downtown New York, where it's a bit dodgy, because you don't really know what you're getting there, because everyone and their uncle's been in that pussy. But in Sweden, it's usually pure.
Especially,
you know?
Princess pussy, probably not much in there.
I'm telling you, I even told her, I said, look, even if you have your period right now, I'm ready to go down it.
Wow.
That's you're a trooper,
one.
Huh?
Yeah, and I'll tell you another thing here.
Okay.
Even the MILFs.
Go back to your notes. Yes. What?
The MILFs look hot here.
The MILFs?
Oh, yeah?
Yep.
Oh, man.
You into the MILF?
Yeah, because it's back to school week, and you see them all with their kids. And they're all looking pretty hot.
Oh, Uncle Paul.
I like this guy.
Oh, there's Uncle Paul.
Yeah, of course. Anytime so, kids
here's
come
some
up.
Swedish chicks for you.
Yay.
You yeah? What do you got? Deep voices for chicks.
Yeah.
Yeah, they like dancing here. They love hip-hop and rap here. I think they all want black cock, these blonde chicks.
Who doesn't?
So what's your big mission, though?
Yeah,
like,
we're confused.
What are you trying to get
you're
from
you're undercover, you're smelling the princess's pussy.
I want a banger, man. That's the whole mission.
Oh, that's it? I thought you were doing a story on her or something.
Well, that's coming out later.
And what's the
mission's accomplished.
What's the gist of the story?
Is just banging royalty, man.
Oh, how I fucked the princess.
Well, I'm on a new film project here. I'm just out to bang as much royalty as possible, and I'm documenting it all.
Jesus, what a life you have.
Why, what celebrity's ready to drop dead over there?
Right. Hey, what do you got on, we got some notes in front of us. I want to know about, my favorite celebrity, Jennifer Aniston.
Of course. What's new with our favorite stinky pussy girl, Jennifer Aniston?
Yeah, her puss stinks, man.
We don't know that. We're assuming that.
I was near her, what was it, 3 years ago at the Toronto Film Festival.
Yeah.
She was promoting some film over there. It was bombed. All her films bombed. I have no idea why I was on the flight up here. You know, they're playing the film that she just did that bombed with Gerard Butler, who's an idiot, too. I mean, can't they get her a better role? This woman's embarrassing herself. I think she just got lucky with Friends. Was she really good in Friends?
I don't know.
Yeah, she was. I watched a couple episodes. She was all right, yeah.
Yeah. Would you bang her?
I bang Jennifer Aniston? Of course. Would you bang Jennifer Aniston, Jimmy?
Dude.
That's an easy one.
I'd lick her feet if they smelled.
Actually,
I would love to fuck her.
Ant's the wild card. Would you bang Jennifer Aniston?
She's not too bad for banging.
She's pretty damn good looking there. Yeah.
Right,
yeah. The problem is her pussy smells.
Out to Sir Anthony. I got to call him Sir now. He's become royalty, too. Sir Anthony.
Thank you, Your Highness.
Your choice, Jill Nicolini or Jennifer Aniston?
I would go with Jennifer Aniston.
See, I'd go with Nicolini, man.
But Jennifer Aniston is just to say you did it, though.
I just want
to
do the Captain Kirk, you know, where no man has gone before. I haven't been there, so I wanted to,
Yeah, he wants to plant some seed.
Something different.
Ew.
Right in our hiney. Planting seed.
Right in our hiney where nothing grows.
Oh, God.
Yeah, she thinks I'm European, dude.
Do you know one time I was fucking a girl and she wanted me to come at her and she said, she said she wanted me to seed her pussy? It really turned me on.
Turn you on?
I want you to seed it. I want to seed that pussy. Oh, so dirty.
You should have went, you're naked, I seed it.
thought he said seed it, so I tortured it like it was in Lost in Something,
Chip.
You know what?
Topical humor.
And I'll tell you this much, too. I would go Aniston over Jolie.
Oh, man.
I know that sounds crazy, but I would. Team fucking Aniston right here.
I don't know about that one, man.
Jolie's nasty, right, Danny?
I am not into that I think Aniston Angelina Jolie.
I don't know.
No way.
I think she's way hotter.
What do you think?
I don't know what it is with Jolie.
You could make Aniston come. That was the problem with her and Brad. She never could orgasm.
Well, he probably didn't want to put his face down there.
Yeah. You gotta lick that snatch.
He smells, man.
You gotta get your face down there, and he was probably like, ugh.
Now, Ian, you gotta credit us. We started the Jennifer Aniston pussy smelling thing, right?
Jesus.
Well, it's true, though. I don't know how you came up with it, but it is true.
Hold on. We're looking at Brad Pitt's cock.
Jesus. Is that what that is?
He's got, like, kind of a rod going, but it's not really.
What an awful dick.
That much.
That's kind of small, right?
Fuck yeah.
Yeah, I think not really.
Maybe he's a grower.
Yeah, but it looks like.
He prepped for that fucking shot.
It looks like he prepped for that picture.
And he blew it.
Because it's too. It's a little too much. It's a little too rigid.
Yeah.
Right there.
Yeah, he prepped.
I think he fucked that up.
Failed.
Yeah.
Epic fail.
Where do I send the photo to here so you could post it up with me and all these hot Swedish chicks?
Yeah, send that fucker over.
Send it to Norton.
I'm going to send it right
Jim
now.
Jim Norton.
Norton. Or is it Norton? Right. How does he say it?
Norton.
He cleaned up. Montreal needs him back.
Yeah, we know that. But Ian,
he's got to move on. He was at Club Soda for about 2 weeks or something. And now they're ready for him, I think, at a bigger venue, man. They loved him.
I would love to go back.
Montreal Gazette.
Ian, we've had you on for 17 minutes. You haven't given us any gossip yet. I mean, it's a terrific phone call, and we're catching up with you. What?
I'm fucking in Sweden, dude. There's no time to do much here except follow the prince. I told her, man, if she was on the rag, I couldn't give a shit. She is just so effing hot.
How do you get close to the princess? Just being you, how did you work it?
Okay, well, I went to this MTV party last night for Fashion Week. Again, there was like 3 guys, 400 chicks. And then we went out to dinner. You couldn't get a reservation, but my contact was able to get me a reservation right next to her, the table next to her.
Mm-hmm.
And I just sauntered over to her again and just started chatting to her. And told her I'm a big fan. We went out. I don't smoke, but she smokes like a chimney, so I started smoking with her. Bodyguards are following her everywhere. She parties so fucking hard, this chick, man.
How old is she?
She's about 26, 27. Here,
26.
Photos. Yeah, she's just... Is she the one...
Is she married?
No.
Okay.
She's not the one. The one,
pull
one
up picture. Princess of fucking...
Yeah, there's one.
One just got married to a personal trainer.
Yeah, there's one that married a regular Joe type guy.
Really?
Just a personal trainer at a gym.
Well.
That's right.
That's a fucking bump up, huh?
Yeah, that's a cool.
But this chick was just in a scandal because her boyfriend, her fiancé, was cheating on her. And then we found out she was cheating on him, too, with the goaltender of the New York Rangers.
Oh.
I mean, couldn't she have chosen someone better, man? Like Jeter, A-Rod. She chose this stiff. Who loses, they choke the Rangers. They're paying them like $6 million a year not to make the playoffs.
Who's your team, Ian?
In the NHL, it's the Montreal Canadiens.
Of course it is.
Of course.
Fuck the Canadiens.
Yeah. Oh,
who else is there, man? When was the last
time? You gotta respect the Islanders.
Do you?
The Islanders, man. One thing, all that I know about the Islanders...
I can't even say that with any passion anymore.
All I know about the Islanders is Jill Nicolini was banging Garth Snow.
Well, that's I guess it's almost a true story.
Everybody knew about
that. Yeah. Hey, Ian. What about the Queen of England? Let's get you back on track. Let's get you back on. You want to talk about smelly pussy. Can you imagine what that smells like?
God.
She's a bit gay, man.
Yeah?
They say she likes pussy. I mean,
well, this is
according to two palace sources, man. I broke this story
palace
on my
horses.
Blog. Now I'm told I won't even be allowed into England. I'm on some list now. They're so pissed off at me. They've asked me to retract. And I refuse to retract.
Ian, how long do we have to be friends with you before you break a big fucking story on our show instead of a blog?
I won't do that to you guys.
I'm banging in Sweden. You can't fucking be.
Right. So the Queen of England
Norton,
loves...
Did you get the pictures? I sent them.
Norton?
What email address, sweetie? I haven't checked.
Norton?
All right. here it is. The real Jim.
Real Jim Norton at Gmail.
Oh, great.
Oh, yeah. I don't mind that.
That's no, I know, but now we got a fish to find his pictures.
How many addresses do you have, dude?
Hey, I have a couple.
Dude, your girlfriend is smoking hot, man.
Oh, thank you. Yeah, she is. She's
like,
she's a
smoking, man. I expect you to be with some Puerto Rican backstage when you told me your girlfriend's there. You know, six kids, and you just jump into the fray. But she's hot, dude.
Yeah, she's a pretty girl.
I mean, she was almost as hot as my Norwegian, or just as hot. I mean, come on, we're not exactly GQ material, you and I. We're walking around with the hottest broads in Montreal.
Yeah, we really are a couple of bags of shit.
Oh, Ian Rolls.
Bags of shit.
Can we go back to the Queen of England? So she likes women? She likes what?
Yeah, she likes puss, man.
She likes scissoring?
Oh, yeah, she.
I don't think they scissor.
Yeah, apparently there's some arrangement, dude. I have no idea, but she sneaks these women into her bedroom.
Still?
It's still, to this day.
Isn't she 80?
She's no bag. You got the photos, Norton?
No, not yet.
Look at the background. I sent you one. Look at the background of the first one. It's all chicks there, man. That's last night.
Damn. You're fucking, you're scoring over there.
Well, dude, if you come to Sweden and don't score, you got serious problems, man. I mean, this whole fucking city's horny.
I mean. All right, so the Queen of England likes girls. All right, what else?
Yes.
What else?
Yeah, by the way, Fergie, I broke that story. That story was my story, dude, about her sleeping with all those Saudi executives.
Oh.
And then it went all over the world. She was, you know, a high-class hooker, Fergie. That's right after the scandal broke about her taking $40K in a suitcase.
Right.
That video.
Yeah.
And then I broke the story. I've had it for months about her being with these Saudi businessmen, and she didn't deny it. She came out and said, yes, I have been with Saudi businessmen, and that's it.
For money? You
know, yes, for cash. Fergie for cash.
Wow.
I wouldn't pay her 2 cents, man, to go down there. I mean,
nah, that's, Fergie's nasty.
Andrew only
not
likes
Fergie.
Redheads,
not Fergie.
Fergie.
Dude,
Fergie.
Have you opened the photos?
Yeah, hold on. I'm checking it right now, buddy.
He really wants you to see
no,
these,
I have a bad connection. I keep checking my thing, but it's not showing up.
Yeah, we...
For girls...
Swedish chicks with their teeth, man. It's like they're just wanting cock right between them, you know? Have you guys ever been to Sweden?
No.
Man,
I've barely been to Canada.
Well, Sirius Radio finance you guys to come over here and broadcast.
They wouldn't finance us to go over the GW Bridge.
And that is the truth.
What's going on with that station?
That is so fucking true.
Is Stern renewing, or what the fuck's going on there?
Don't know. I mean,
no one knows anything.
I know a few things, but yeah. I'll keep it to myself.
I heard that they're a weird thing with Howard. Like,
with all the money.
Howard wants $100 million, and they're saying, look, would you do it for $50 a week? They're trying to talk everybody down. It's just
$50.
Yeah. How about $50 and a nice chair?
A Jew, man.
What?
He's being a true Jew.
Oh, whatever.
No, look, anybody thing. Negotiating, dude, I don't fault anybody for trying to negotiate for the most they can get, like, talent-wise.
Yeah.
I never fault the fucking
goes back
performer
and forth.
For that.
That's right.
They knock things back and forth.
That's where we're brothers, trust me.
Yeah.
Because management, in the end, will try to screw you over.
Always.
So whatever he gets, God bless him.
You got them by the balls. Like, who the fuck
oh, really?
You guys?
Really?
Yeah, you guys got the following.
Oh, really?
Yeah. You
really?
Norton's not going anywhere.
You could say that again in this business.
In life.
See, you guys could keep asking for more. Now that I hear they're charging for ads over there.
We ought to have Ian represent
us. Yeah, no kidding. No kidding.
You know who loves you guys? And she's a great friend of mine.
Who?
I'm very tight with her. Judith Regan.
I like Judith a lot.
I like Judith. We've had her on the show.
She loves you guys. She respects
you. Really?
Yeah, Judith is my girl, man.
Check that out. Pass that around. That's a fucking good one. And pass that over. That's a good shot.
I was recently. She had a flood in her apartment.
We're not listening to you. Jimmy's passing around a picture. Hold on, Ian.
That's the background.
Jesus Christ. Is that you?
Of course it is.
Wow.
It's turgid. What's the term you use?
Turgid.
Turgid.
Jesus, Jimmy.
What the fuck? We're looking at Jimmy's boner picture.
A profile of a hands-on hip boner.
But dude,
shot.
That was a couple of years ago where I was like 15 pounds lighter, and I had the Superman pose and just my dick.
The Superman hands-on
here's
hip
the Ian.
Pose.
I got one of your pictures. These guys are fucking hot, man.
Yeah, let's take
Ian gets hot chicks. Look at this, Dan.
Let me take a look at Ian. Yeah, Ian, that's a hot broad. Who's the princess?
Nice.
Here, I'll send you the princess.
Really pretty, man.
Yeah,
I'm
very
gonna
nice.
Check out your other
very
one
nice.
There.
You got your saxophone over there in Sweden?
Nah, you know what? I, I like to travel light, man. I just like to travel with a few clothes, a bag of condoms, and that's it, man.
Why condoms?
I don't beat
condoms
around the bush.
You put gum there instead or a hat.
Fuck that. Yeah.
I've brought 94 condoms with me. And I have about maybe 57 left.
Okay. Jeez. Why? I would be flinging them.
Yeah, exactly. I'd have 90. If I brought 94 with me, I'd have 95 left.
I'm going to put some on eBay.
Yeah, used.
I know all the chicks listening to this show would love to have His Highness's used condoms.
Oh, yeah.
How come I'm looking at some pictures here, some video of girls grimacing?
What?
They're, like,
oh,
some
really?
Of the yeah, they're like, ooh.
Ian, American Idol.
Oh, yeah. American Idol. Well, I'm not a big fan of this Steven Tyler thing now. I think the guy is dead. I don't even think it's him anymore, man. The guy's just lost his mind. You heard he shoved Joe Perry off his stage.
No, Joe Perry.
Perry shoved him. Well,
we're,
then he shoved
I think,
him back
I think we're,
Toronto.
I think we're Team Perry on this one, too, man.
Yeah.
The video's great. We talked about it earlier, but basically Joe Perry hip-checked Steven Tyler off the stage.
Yeah, it was a great check. I saw the video.
You got to think he did it on purpose, right? He's a little pissed off by the announcement that he's joining Idol.
He's known to be a prick, you know. First of all, the guy tries to imitate Mick Jagger for the last 30 years and not too well. And he's just neurotic, man, you know. He has a bad rep. I think they tried to replace him. Because the band was going to break up, they were looking for, and then they got back together. I think they should have replaced them.
I'm sending
over the princess with me now. This is at 3 in the morning last night. So His Highness is looking a bit rough there, so is the princess.
Hey, Your Highness, we had Montana Fishburne on the show yesterday.
Well, what did she say, man?
Well, we fucked it up a little bit. We weren't well prepared. We should have called you for some knowledge. But she was all right. She was cool.
Yeah, she's a nice person. She was nice.
Have you seen the porno?
No, but I heard that it was all because her dad used to have a lot of porn magazines around the house, and she became obsessed with porn at an early age. Did she say that?
No.
Yeah, dad apparently. He's been cussing her out for doing the porn, but he's the biggest pimp daddy himself. So, you know, the guy's a pervert.
Wow. A pervert?
Yeah, look, the apple doesn't fall far from the tree here, and you got to look at the situation.
That's on a hill.
She was influenced by something, and apparently it was because he was into a lot of, you know, adult porn and magazines and stuff like that. They'd be around the house.
Wow. Well, we didn't know that.
Would you do her?
Yeah.
Sure no. Would.
Yeah,
nope.
Although there's some shit going on around her ass and stuff, but.
Oh, yeah?
Not even close to doing that.
Yeah.
What does she have, some colitis around the ass or something?
It's like, quite frankly, the more we studied it, it looks like cigarette fucking burns.
Yeah, it looked like someone, like, burnt her ass with cigarettes and it kind of, you know, put, like, dark spots on her ass.
Yeah, that might be, a lot of chicks, they have plastic surgery around their butt.
Oh, maybe some lipo.
Frank Ryan, have you heard of him? He just died.
Yeah.
He's the most famous... famous plastic surgeon in Hollywood, and she might have got some work done around there.
Mm-hmm.
That's why. A lot of black chicks, man, they have that ass, you know? Like, they look great, and then their skin, there's all kinds of blotches around the ass, and, you know, so who knows?
It's hard to have a lot of melanin, I guess, you know?
Yeah, where's Carlisi today, man?
The stretch mark.
You can say that any day of the week.
Do you have a problem with him, too?
No, I like Carlisi. He's a straight shooter, but you guys must be
right in your mouth.
Opie and Steve, I mean, babies. How the fuck is this show going so smooth?
Oh, you're finally acknowledging me, Ian, after a half hour of radio. I appreciate that.
Well, dude, you're the man.
Yeah, I know I am.
See, I don't have to acknowledge you because you're famous. Everyone knows who you are. Anthony Norton, a bit of a different story.
Yeah, okay. That's how it works.
What did you think of Montreal, man?
I love it.
Yeah, we all love Montreal.
It is a very, very cool city.
I've never been.
Ian, is it time for a blind item?
Yeah. Actually, I have a new blind item today.
Something good?
Yeah. Well, what American royal figure has been linked officially now to the Swedish monarchy?
American royal. Now, when you say, besides Ian Halpern?
I won't say. That looks true, man.
You can't do a blind item about yourself.
Exactly.
You know, I finally figured out Ian Halperin, and it's probably more inside than anything. But no, some of the listeners will get it. He's a cross between Dice. We see that,
yeah,
right?
A little bit.
And,
dude,
and hold on. And Bruce Mittman.
A little Mittman.
A little Mittman-ish?
Yeah, I can see a little Mittman-ish.
Our old boss from AF.
Between me and them,
he's the
I actually sell coffee.
Well, I was going to explain it, so
my last movie,
statement didn't mean nothing to everybody, but he had to keep talking.
The world.
So.
Who the fuck has done that in one night?
Wow. Yeah, no one, Ian. No one.
You know, I have another book coming out shortly. You got to hit, man. You got to put up numbers in this business. Otherwise, it's, you know, it's just more smoke than fire, man, and it goes nowhere.
Yeah. So what happened to the plastic surgeon? He drove off a cliff? Was it by accident?
I don't know, dude.
Twittering.
I think somebody got even with
Twittering, you think?
They said he might have been tweeting, yeah.
Wow.
Another Twitter-related death.
I'd like to know where she was that day.
Nice. I think she liked him.
Yeah.
He created her.
Wow.
Maybe it was the ex-hubby there. Have you had him on the...
Ian, did you realize how smart I just was?
Yes.
I said he created her. That's a pretty good, clever line right there.
Man. He did create
her. Thank you. She's completely different now.
Absolutely. He looks a bit Swedish, too, now. He probably, you know... You know Paul Anka's ex-wife? She's the most... Anna Anka?
Anna
her,
Anka.
Man. Google her.
Googler?
Googler.
Anna Anka?
She's the biggest skank in Sweden, man. She divorces Anka.
Yeah.
She claims she's 30. She has a reality show here.
Did she make a fucking maniac out of him? Is that what happened?
Oh, that guy, yeah.
She gave him plastic surgery, too.
Wow, she's
just Google her, man.
We're Googling.
How old do you think she is?
All right.
Google image her right now.
Yeah.
Well, all right, hold on.
You can tell she's had some work.
Is that her, too? All right, she's
60.
No, stop. Give me another picture.
60.
Oh, shit. All right. Am I? Wow. I would say, fuck, I might be right. I'll go 55.
Yeah, see, man, she claims she's 37 here.
Come on.
That's not 37.
With the head of Channel 5 here for lunch. Nice woman, Christina Eriksson, her name is. Really cool chick. We had lunch and we started talking about her. She tells me she's 37. I say, dude, I've seen this chick on TV, man. She looks older than fucking Phyllis Diller. Like, she says, no way, she's 37. Like, I mean, unless she's been fucking nonstop, you know, a bunch of guys from the Congolese, there's no way she's 37.
Yeah, no, not at all. So, yeah.
Yeah, that looks pretty... pretty bad for 37.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
You can only pad that age so many years before people go, wow, you look horrible for your age.
Tell me about it.
Now, here's the difference between
I fucking
Sweden
blew it.
And Norway.
Stopped 5 years ago with that horse shit. What?
I was just in Oslo for 10 days, and now I'm in Stockholm. And
you're
I'm
a world traveler. Ian, where do you get all your money to travel? Like, you're all over the place.
Dude,
you
check your bank accounts, man. Don't you know there's some cash is missing, man?
Oh, is that it? You're extorting?
Yeah.
Embezzling, I mean?
Yeah.
I got my peeps, man. You know, they invest in His Highness because they know they're going to get a minimum 20-to-1 return.
20-to-1?
Absolutely.
How do I get in on that action?
Yeah, that's some good action.
You know, you could just wire me the money right here. That's what, you know, when I walk into the room today, she said the first thing, you know, where's this all going? I said, look, you invest money in His Highness, you're getting 20-to-1. Not Madoff type 20-to-1, but real 20-to-1.
Right.
And then she checks the track record and sees, yeah, this guy actually, yeah, maybe, you know, a lot of people make fun of him, they don't like him, but he makes money.
Mm-hmm.
And that's the key, dude. I sleep well at night.
You're making money.
Dude, I'm sleeping right now on fucking, I'm not sleeping in IKEA, Swedish bed. I'm sleeping in the Royal Palace here, the Royal Suite, at some fucking hotel overlooking the square. Why?
Overlook.
Because I'm delivering A-Raw type numbers in this business. I'm making it better for everyone. I'm creating new waves. You know, and I'm going to take you guys along because eventually Sirius will fire you guys. You always
do. Eventually. No, you are correct there.
Shit.
You know, we'll write a book together and sell 5 million copies. We'll be bigger than Private Parts.
What percent you want, though?
Well, that's, you know, force him here, right?
No, we're not going 25.
25 points each, and I'll get Judith Regan is the fucking hottest chick ever in publishing. And the nicest person.
I like Judith a lot. I've done her show.
Yeah, she's all right.
She's a fucking...
I know she does.
You know, she sings your praises like she does to Stern.
Right.
Stern hasn't had me on recently. I think because I'm on your show.
Really?
That, yeah, like honestly, Stern,
that happens with some of the guests.
Maybe, but
I don't know for sure. But
honestly, we have so many people going back and forth between the shows at this point. Yeah. I don't think anybody cares.
And you're royalty.
You know, I'm the only guy he's ever danced with. Every time I go on his show, he dances with me for some reason.
Because you're sexy. Who wouldn't want to cuddle up with you?
I think he likes big cock, big Jewish cocks. vicariously through me.
Ian, I don't even know if we've accomplished anything with this phone call today, sir.
Put one woman on the phone for me, please. I'm in Stockholm. Put on some American...
Haven't you been in this studio?
Ian, I would love to do that, but I haven't seen a phone ring in the last 40 minutes. Ann Coulter was in. Holy shit. They were lit.
Them phones were ringing.
She looks like a fucking... You know, she looks like she's been run over by a truck, man.
You don't like Ann Coulter?
Look, I've seen her in the green room at Geraldo's show. And she looked, they have to spend more time on doing makeup than her than anything else.
I think she looks good, dude, honestly.
On a makeup chair longer than Ann Coulter.
I'm not just saying this because I'm friends with her. I think she actually looks good.
She's no kid, you know. It's...
Would you fuck her?
Yeah, of course I would.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, but it's like, I don't get those kind of vibes from her at all.
No.
Not even a little flirty. She's not flirty. She's really nice, but she's not sexually flirty.
She was a little flirty out with those drinks.
Not with me.
She has a bit of an Adam's apple.
I think you got a drink.
What's that?
She has a bit of an Adam's apple.
She's a very slender lady.
Once you get a few drinks in her, I think I'd have a shot.
She can go wild?
Yeah. I think she's got that wild streak in her after a few drinks.
Yeah, I think I'd like to see... Remember that... designated hitter for the Yankees, Chili Davis.
Oh, fucking Chili Davis.
I'd like to see Chili Davis go down on Ann Coulter.
What the fuck? What an odd thing to
But that's why we need him on the show. You know, who would come up with that?
I want to see Cecil Fielder rape Jennifer Aniston with a bat. Why? And by that, I mean the animal.
Young captain. Holy shit.
Well, Ian, we don't want to waste your phone bill.
No, we love you in Sweden, man.
Thank you, Ian Halperin.
Look, dude, if I get arrested for going down on this chick tonight, you guys got to bail me out. You got to get all your listeners. You're not going to leave me in the Swedish pokey, will you?
That can't be that bad. A Swedish jail?
Yeah,
that
can't
be bad. It's got to probably be nice.
Right.
All the cheese you could eat.
Yeah, I think it is co-ed.
Do you think I'll bang the princess tonight?
Not a chance in hell.
Look at the photo, man. I sent it to Norton.
Norton.
Look how close we are last night.
Did you see the photo, Norton? No. Yeah, he can't be bothered. It's basically what he just said.
My connection's bad.
With his eyes. What?
My connection is
bad. His connection's bad, Ian.
All right, guys.
We'll get it.
Let me give you the plug.
All right, go ahead.
This is His Highness listening to Opie and Anthony show and Norton. Number one radio show in the world. Pleasure to be here. Peace out to everybody.
Pleasure.
Sirius Radio. XM, number one show on the planet, and they keep getting higher and higher. You know that song, Higher and Higher?
Yes.
One of my favorite songs. That should be your guys' theme song. Nobody's stopping the O&A train.
Can you sing us out with a song or something?
Give music, buddy.
Yes. Please.
What do you want to sing us?
This song is coming for you guys.
Okay.
Right now, just give me 10 seconds.
No, that means you're queuing up something. We want to hear you sing.
Here you go. This is... For everybody at the Opie and Anthony show, a dedication from His Highness, and here we go.
Yes. Pleasing Saddles?
Yeah.
Yeah.
No.
No, what movie?
No, it's... It's Dino.
Yeah, no, I know that, but...
Yeah, the beginning sounded like that.
Ian, could you sing along to it at least?
Ian left.
Really?
Yeah, he's just going to sit here and leave this music playing like we do to the listeners sometimes. he is such an ass. He just put this on.
And I like to think he's still there. No, he's long gone. Ian.
What an ass.
Amore.
When you dance down the street with old Dean Martin.
You're in love.
When you walk. It's nice. It's pleasant, right? You're not dreaming, senor. Dino Martinelli? Little Dino Martinelli?
Excuse me, but you see back in old Napoli.
That's amore. It's really bringing the guinea out in me.
Moon hits your eye like the fist of your husband. That's typical. When you practice religion and then go fuck your gumar on Friday, that's typical.
When the spaghetti hits the wall, when the spaghetti hits the wall, that's so typical.
When you say rest in peace about a guy you've murdered for protection money, that's typical. When you go to the funeral of a friend who you betrayed for a few dollars, that's typical. When you put a gun in the face of an honest man and take his money, that's typical. And then complain about how the neighborhood's not what it used to be, that's typical. When you babble about food and your mother that nobody cares about, that's typical.
Scusa me. That's amore.
Amore. That's amore.
Right.